So Don, I woke up this morning at 2:45, as always, and went on Twitter, and I saw.
And thanks for the text.
I texted you soon after, but the reason I texted you is because Dave Chappelle released a brand new, unannounced special on Netflix at midnight called 8:46. Obviously, that is the length of time that George Floyd had a knee on his neck and died in the process. Dave Chappelle put out this special. In it, though, he addresses you directly. I mean, really directly. You, on TV a couple weeks ago, called on Hollywood, specifically Black Hollywood, to come out, take a stand publicly. And I want to play for you now what Dave Chappelle had to say about that.
And I'm watching Don Lemon, that hotbed of reality. He says, where are all these celebrities? Why aren't you talking? Does it matter about celebrity? No. This is the streets talking for themselves. They don't need me right now. I kept my mouth shut. And I'll still keep my mouth shut. But don't think that my silence is complicit.
I got to say, first of all, I was only able to listen to a little bit more of it. It's fascinating and really deep. And there is irony, Don, in the fact that he's attacking you for calling on celebrities to speak out. And he's doing just that in this special. But what does it feel like to have Dave Chappelle talking about you like that?
Well, Dave Chappelle is my favorite comedian. And I do care what Dave Chappelle says. And I actually, well, first of all, I think my nieces and nephews will actually give me, you know, some props because they'll think I'm cool now that Dave Chappelle has mentioned my name. And I'm actually honored to be memorialized in a Dave Chappelle special. That's an entire special. So I'm excited about that. But what I will say is that I actually agree with Dave Chappelle. I agree that I think the establishment has been a bit behind, and some of what we created, and I consider myself a part of the establishment because I'm over 40 years old. I think that the young people who are out there in the streets don't really care what we have to say. They think that part of the world that we created, maybe, and what we did, maybe we didn't move fast enough, or we weren't strong enough, and so they're out there fighting. They said, "Listen, we are tired of what's happening. We've tried to do it nicely. We've tried to do it peacefully. We've tried to do all of these things, and you have rejected it." And so I think that they're not only speaking to the white people in this country, but also to all of us in the establishment. And so I agree with him in that way. But I do think that this is a moment, not a moment for modesty. I think it's a moment that we should all be using our platform to do whatever we can. And at least to show those young people and those people out there that we support them. And it doesn't mean taking all of the, you know, all the credit for it or speaking out for them. I think that they can do that on their own. I think that's exactly right. But I think that they need to know that people like Dave Chappelle, like me, or whoever supports them. And that's all they need to know. But the irony is that his special is called 8:46. He's talking about this issue. And I think it's great. He's using his platform to talk about this in the way that he can. So, listen, I'm not beyond reproach or criticism. I actually welcome it. And Dave can come on my show and he can talk about it anytime. I think, especially with this, I think many people have been sort of incredulous about, oh my gosh, somebody criticized me or someone, you know, is challenging me. We should all be challenged. And I actually welcome Dave to criticize me, talk about me, call me, whatever. I think it's a moment where we have two men of color who have two big platforms. We are agreeing or disagreeing with each other and having a discussion, and people are actually paying attention to it. So that's how I feel about that.
There you go. I mean, actually, you can do both. The street can talk loudly, and the people with megaphones can talk loudly. Don?
Allison, listen, what I was saying, the sentiment I have with that is that when you think about Lena Horne and Ossie Davis and Ruby Dee and all of those people who, from the civil rights movement, celebrities, artists, artists should reflect the times, right? Artists should not be behind the times. They should reflect the times. And all of those people stood on their perch and they yelled loudly. Yeah. And that's, I think that those young people need as much support as possible. That's it.
Don, great to talk to you. Great to have your voice on New Day. Thanks so much for waking up and being with us.
Can I go back to bed now?
You may. You may.